Hello everyone, I'm Surabhi. Welcome to my channel. Today's busy book is for my 7-year-old. She just turned 7-year-old. She's a year in baby. And here we are doing critical thinking and spatial reasoning. It's all logical thing, no addition, subtraction, but all critical thinking questions. So let's start with the first one. So here, this is, you have to find the pet of each of the person as per the clues. So there are three people, A, B, and C. And there are three pets, a cat, a dog, and a fish. I have given the clues. According to the clues, you have to figure out who has which pet. Like, the first clue is C found his pet crying in the tree. So what does it mean? Can it be a fish? No. Can it be a dog? Or can it be a cat? Okay, so C does not have a fish as a pet. But B's pet sleeps in B's bed every night. So who sleeps in your bed? It can be a cat or it can be a dog. So what do you think? So dog does not climb up the tree, but cat does. So basically, C's pet was cat. B's pet sleep in her bed. So B's pet will be dog. And A's pet is left to be fish. That is what, so she has to infer this information from the clues. Second critical question is again similar one. You have to find the right bowl. So there is a smaller bowl, a big bowl, and a medium sized bowl. So there's again three people, A, B, C. What is the clue? C's bowl will fit into A's bowl. It means the bowl of the C is smaller than the bowl of A, because that's why it fits into bowl of A. And B's bowl is smaller than C's bowl. So B's is smaller than C, and C is smaller than A, right? Yeah, so basis on that, I will figure out. So I have to read the pen, but that is how the logic is, that they have to figure out whose bowl is what. So it means B's bowl is smallest and C's bowl is medium and A's bowl is the biggest. So yes, that's how we are going to figure it out question. I'll see what she can do. Again, my expectations are not that she can do all of this, but just it's about thinking of different ideas. Maybe she has some other idea, do it, we'll see. This one is find the hidden shapes. So I have made shapes here which has different shapes in it. Like if you cut it like this, you get a triangle. If you cut it like this, you get a square. Then you get a triangle here again. Then you get semicircle, again rectangle. So these are the two shapes in which I have tried to make, hide other shapes. And I want to see that can she figure out. So here also, like in this one, if you draw a line from here to here, then it will be a semicircle. This will be a triangle. Again, a square here, a rectangle. Just a fun exercise that how many shapes can she found in cutting these ones. Thinking again. Again, it's a puzzle. Simple puzzle. It's about height. So I have drawn different poles of different heights. There are five. So one in the middle size. So dash is taller than dash, but smaller than this. So what will be? So basically it will be a middle sized thing which is taller than this. So it can be D, because D is taller than E, but smaller than C. It can be any of the middle, not the longest and shortest, any three of them it can be. Now D is shorter to what and what, but taller than this. And last one is that is in the middle for height comparison. So whose height is in the middle? So I think I have made D in the middle. So basically these questions are very, very easy. After I think this much of load, she deserves the easy question. So that's how it is. Simple busy book, more of a thinking kind of questions for her. And hope you enjoyed it. Bye bye.